Hello world, my name is Lisa, and if you don't already know, I am about hair, makeup, nails, and subscription boxes. And today I received an Ipsy Glam Bag Plus that I will be opening for you. So let's take a look. If you don't already know, this is a $35 bag. Because everything comes in a bag, which is very cute this month for, I don't know, maybe somebody. I have so many bags, I don't keep them all. It's cute. Not quite my style, but that's okay. No big deal. I didn't do my makeup because I picked, you get five things and I picked three, and I know that two of them are makeup. So I decided to do my makeup with you in the video. So first things, we have the bag. We're gonna put that down there. We've got this is Visart. It's just a little cute compact eyeshadow, and I believe there's six shadows in it. It's a little mirror. Oh, let's take this off. And this is one item that I picked. Satisfying when you pull the little safety seal off the mirrors. I think anyways. Let's see, we've got the swatched, all right. Actually, they swatched really nice. I love Visart, or however you say it, I'm not really sure, but I've got two of their other palettes and I just adore them. Okay, yeah, these aren't too bad. Actually, they're really good. These are the colors. Start with this one right here. I have no idea what the name is because they do not give you a name. They don't give me a name. Yeah, there's nothing on there. I'm just going to go in, do nice transition color of the pink, and then I'll go on with this dark pink right here. Go around my crease. Ooh, that is pretty, really pigmented. It's really pretty though, but fades out nicely. I want to say nicely, but if you're looking for a real bright color, like when you first put it on, that's not what you're going to get with this. And then I will put a little bit more on here. I have hooded eyes horribly, so when I do my crease, I have to go up a little bit farther than most people, unless you have the same type of eyes, so you understand what I mean. But anybody, just a real quick tip, anybody that has a problem with their upper lid waterline eyeliner transferring to like right here, what I do is I put my eyeliner on first before my eyeshadow. Then I take a clear translucent powder. Sorry, look in the camera, Lisa, look in the camera. And then I take, anyways, the translucent powder, and I just gently go over and make sure it's clear so you don't put any extra color on your eyes or anything, but go over just where your eyelid, your eyebrows are. Ooh, your eyebrows, not your eyebrows, scratch that. Your eyelashes. Take just a little bit of that powder, because if you are like me and you wear a, you know, a primer on your lids, you're gonna want to put some translucent powder on that anyways, so you can put your eyeshadow on nice and, you know, smoothly. But anyways, just put a little bit of that over on your, make sure you do your eyeliner first and then put it on, then do the translucent powder. I hope that came out right. But do that and you will get no eyeliner transfer. I learned that from somebody on YouTube. Couldn't tell you who. Could have been Wayne Goss. I watch his videos all the time. I absolutely love him. He's just from heaven. He's an angel sent from heaven for us makeup people. I'm going to go on then with this brown on my lid. Brown is, it looks really dark in the pan, but it is not. And I'm guessing when I go to blend this out, that it is going to fade a little. Let's put a little more. Let's put some up here too. A little more in the actual lower part of the crease because I want you to be able to see it. Kind of like a gradient. Just use the camera mirror. Then let's do a little bit of this purple here. We'll put that just I'm not a finger user. Like I can't dip my fingers in and put it on my lid because I got fat fingers. Like, sorry, it just works better without a nail here. Sorry, but my fat fingers get all over my lids and it does not look very good. But there's always a way around. Can't see very well because it's not going on. It is a little bit. Probably should use my finger, but I'm not going to. Hold out, Lisa. You can do it. You don't need to use your finger. You can use a brush. You can do it. It's okay. I like it. I just wish the colors were a little more vibrant. And I wish this shimmer shade was more shimmery. They swatched beautifully, but honestly, as you can tell, they're just not showing up real well on my eye. And that just goes to show you, never go on swatches because you just might not get what you expect. So what I'm going to do is probably use a different shimmer shade from a different palette. Use this Modern Renaissance real quick and then I will finish opening my bag. I don't want to say unboxing because it's not a box. Let's try this. This usually goes on really well. The shimmers from this palette. This Anastasia Beverly Hills Modern Renaissance palette. If any of you get BoxyCharm and Ipsy, you probably got it just in the past, I don't know, a few months or so. I love it. I use it a lot. Where it had been all my life, I have no idea. I will do my other eye off camera. This is it. That's my look. Okay, let me leave real quick. I'll be right back to do my other eye, or to show you my both eyes. Back. Okay, I did my other eye. I took the shimmer off because you know what? I just didn't like it. So this is what they look like. I am going to just put a little bit, sorry about the noise, of this pink right here underneath hair, underneath my lid, or underneath my bottom lashes. And then I will go in with that dark brown again that I put on my lower lid. And just put it just halfway across, because I find I have kind of, oh, I don't know what you would call it. Now, I may be almond shaped, but they're like, I don't know, pointy at the ends or whatever. I guess they're almondy. And anyways, if I put this all the way across, it makes my eyes a little bit smaller. Just putting it halfway from here to here opens my eyes up a little bit more. I never have been a person who puts eyeliner all the way across my lower lid, because like I said, it makes my eyes a little bit smaller. Sorry, I keep looking over here instead of over here, but yeah. The reason why I have a little bit of darkness, a little bit of eyeliner right here, is from the transfer from my upper water lid. But anyways, I'm going to, well, again, this is the Vice Art little cute little palette. It's a little teeny baby palette. But now I am going to put some lashes on. Got these Moxie lashes the other day and I absolutely love them. So let me do that real quick. Just going to throw this eyeliner. It's the magnetic liner, because these are magnetic lashes. Put it across the top of my lid, like so. Oh yeah. It says to wait 3 minutes, but I'm ADHD, I don't have 3 minutes, you know what I mean? And it works just fine. For us people that live in the fast lane. Living life in the fast lane. All right. Let's see. Wrong one. These are, well, they look like this. They are the Wear Me, Share Me, no? Wear Me, Share Me Moxie Lash? I guess it's called Wear Me, Share Me. Anyways. So that is this one. One down, one to go. I'll do that off camera. Give me just a second. Okay. I'm back. Got my lashes on. Now for the second, well, actually, let me just show you what else is in the bag, and then the last things I need to get ready, I will show you and we'll do them together. So I picked three. I told you that. I picked the little palette. I also picked this. It's called Symbiosis London. It's a silicic and zincadone. Silicic and zincadone, whatever that is, but blemish treatment serum. So it says smooth a pea-sized amount into gentle circular motions onto the skin in the morning and evening after cleansing. So I'm guessing you put it on if you have a breakout, or if you have acne, or if you just have one little pimple, you can just stick it on there. Then I also got Mud Masky Serum Infused Eye Mask. It's for dark circles, puffy eyes, fine wrinkles, dry skin, and swelling. And this is another good brand. I've got a lot of their stuff. Works really well. Stuff for your hair and your face. And then I also got this Tarte C Hydro Sealer Concealer. So I'm going to be putting this on right now. And I got the color Light Medium Honey 25H. Never tried this before, but I'm excited to. It looks a little dark for the foundation that I have on right now, but Hey, we're in it to win it, so let's see what happens. Let's see. This is the color right here, but if I blend it out, it's not too bad. It's a little dark, but I also kind of got it in my swatch, so let's see what happens. Seems like it's gonna dry quick, so I am going to just put one on at a time here. Yeah, it's a little thick. It dries a little fast, so you might not want to put it all over your face and then go to blend it out. Uh-oh, got a little on my stuff, but that's okay. I don't usually do my eyes all before I do my concealer, so that's okay. Anything goes with makeup, right? Some people are like, oh, you can't do this, you can't do that, you have to have this, you have to... No, I mean, honestly, yeah, it's nice. A lot of the times I use my concealer, make it a little bit lighter than my foundation, but you know what? You don't have to. You really don't. Sometimes I make my concealer a little darker than my foundation. The way I look at makeup is an art, and there's no rules in art. It's all about uniqueness and your personal preference, and if it makes you feel beautiful, then do it, you know? I personally would never wear black lipstick, but you know what? It's okay if you do, because if you look in the mirror and it's beautiful to you, other people are going to see it and go, wow, she's beautiful, or he's beautiful. Like, it is what it is. And I'm going to look at it just as much and say, wow, I wish I could wear black lipstick because they wear it so well. Just be confident in what you like and what you wear, and everything is beautiful. So, you know, don't think that you have to do this or you have to do that when it comes to makeup, or you have to put your concealer a certain place, or you're not allowed to put concealer over here. No, you can put it wherever the heck you want. Like me, I don't always do it exactly the same, but right now I'm doing it like this because I get red around here, so I'm putting it there. And I have a little bit of red and darkness under here. Plus, I want to kind of even the color out. But you know what? It actually matches my foundation pretty well. It's not lighter. It's not darker. It's just pretty much the same. So I think that works out just fine. And instead of, a lot of people say, because I have a bit of a wider nose, you could say. And I never got a nose job, so I wear a wide nose and I love it. I think it's beautiful. I like wide noses, to be honest with you. But a lot of people say, oh, you know, to bring that in, just take some contour and contour your nose. Well, every time I contour, I get these dark lines that is noticeably contour. Like, I'm just not that good at it. So what I do, and it didn't work very much with this one, but I just take my concealer and I put it down my nose, and then I just take this and I just gently go like this. I don't rub it in, and you can kind of see down my nose that it already looks contoured. I mean, to me it does anyway. So, but anyways, that's just my two cents. Doesn't mean anything. I'm not a makeup artist, you know, a professional one by any means. I'm a makeup artist in my home, in my mirror. I'm a makeup artist, and that's how everybody, I think, should feel. So, we have one more item. Anyways, this is my concealer from Tarte. It is, what it is again? The Hydro Sealer. I love it. I love it. And then I got one more thing, and it is, I love this, the Ciate London Everyday Vacay Setting Mist. I've had this before, and I used it one time, and I absolutely loved it. I had makeup on and I didn't wash my face before I went to bed because I kind of went out that night and I wasn't in any condition to wash my face before I went to bed. So anyways, so I fell asleep with my makeup on, woke up the next day and it looked exactly the same. Like I looked like I was ready to go out. I was so impressed. And guess what? I went to use it again and my dumb butt dropped it because I have the dropsies all the time. Broke this top off. Isn't this beautiful? Broke the top off and there was no gluing, there was no fixing it. So I took this and I just kept pouring it into my Cover X bottle because it has a little, you know, shaker in it and I love it. And it mists instead of sprays. Anyways, so I used it like that. But this is such a good mister, just like that. It's another reason I love it. Let's see here. It's very misty. It's not, you don't ever get big, thick raindrops on your face. Well, it's a little more than misty, but you don't get raindrops. And it smells like a honeydew melon. There we go. So, well, that is everything I have in my Ipsy Plus $35 glam bag. But I'm gonna go ahead and finish my makeup. So if you wanna hang out, I will show you what I do. I'm gonna use the Too Faced Cocoa Contour palette. And I'm gonna use medium contour right here. I love this palette because it truly does smell like cocoa. Or chocolate, either one, you know, both the same really. But yeah, it smells like chocolate and it is amazing. I love it. I can smell the chocolate like right now. It's not really overbearing or overpowering by any means. It just smells good, especially when I don't have any chocolate because I am a chocolate lover. But yeah, I wish I could tell you all how much everything costs in my Ipsy, but they give you this little card right here, and that's on the back. You open it up, and it just tells you some tips on some of the products you get, but it doesn't tell you how much everything is. I could look it up, but I didn't do that. But anyways, I'll leave a link at the down below if you don't already get Ipsy. This is a gift your friend, a free palette, share the beauty. And so if you sign up, you'll get a free palette worth $18. So yeah, but I love Ipsy. They always they contribute each month to my makeup and skincare collection. It's a good way to say it. I always bring my blush up just a little bit. Sometimes I'll bring it up all the way, actually, just if I feel my contour isn't setting real good or something, I'll just do that. Sometimes I put a little here, a little there. Again, no rules. Do what you feel like doing. And then I will put some lips on real quick. Ooh, that's dark. I am not one to overline my lips. A lot of people do it, but just not for me, I guess. I don't like when you can see the lipstick and the lip liner on your skin. I think, well, it's just not for me. I don't like it on me. I think other people look beautiful when they do theirs, but not me. I think I look silly. Especially down below here. Oh, I can't stand it when I get it all down here. It drives me nuts. And we will use, this was the Thrive Cosmetics. I have no idea what color it is. It just looks like this. And this is my MAC Bullet lipstick in the shade raised breath, maybe. Can't read without my glasses, sorry. Here you are, hi. All right, got her on. And there I go. So this is my look for tonight. Hey, there you are again. I don't want to talk to those people anymore. I want to talk to you. All right. This is me in my whole makeup. And guess what I get to do? I'm so excited I get to wear it to bed. No, I will wash my face first, but no, I'm not going anywhere. I'm not doing anything. I just wanted to do it for you. All right, guys, take care, and we'll see you next time. Bye.